Dear students, in today's session, we are going to learn about Python's file handling. In file handling, we are studying how to read content of a file. Okay, so before going to read, we should open a file first. That means, before any manipulation you are performing, you have to open a file. Now, let us see how can we open a file. So, for opening a file, Python gives you a function called open. Open, and within bracket, this open function has two parameters or two arguments. The first parameter is always the name of the file which you want to open. For example, here I am giving it as best.txt since it is a text file. Close the double quotes, put one comma, and the second parameter is the mode of accessing the file. Here we are going to read data from the file. So mode of opening you have to give is R. R means reading. Okay, then close the file. And this open function always returns an a file object or a file handle. So we have to receive those file handle to a variable. We can use, for example, fin here. So I am writing fin is equal to open best.txt R. Now let us run this program, and I'm saving it as a file 4. See, you got an error message. What is the error here? File not found error. No such file or directory best.txt. That means when you are opening a file in the read mode, that file should exist in the Python's directory. In this case, this best.txt is not existing in the Python's folder. That's why you got an error message. Okay. Now let us change this best.txt to demo.txt. Once again, you run and see. Yeah. Now there is no error. That means this demo.txt is existing in the Python's folder. Now let us read data from the file. For reading data from the file, we have a function called read. In order to use that read function, you should use the file handle fin. We can use fin.read. Okay. So this read function reads the entire content of the file starting from the cursor position. So in order to receive this, we can use a variable called data. Data equal to fin.read. Now let us display this data, print data. So after the operations, you should close the file. For closing the file, we have a function called close. So we should use the file handle fin.close. Now let us run this program. See, you got the entire content from the demo.txt file. So these are the content of the demo.txt file. See, for example, this is the demo.txt file. It contains, we are learning Python, reading files in Python, or some sentences are there. Okay. Now that means the read function reads the entire content of a file starting from the cursor position. A cursor is a file pointer which always points to the beginning of the file when you are opening a file in the read mode. And you can also change or move the file pointer to a particular location. For moving the file pointer, Python gives you a function called seek. You can use fin.seek. Okay. For example, here I am giving it as seek of 7. That means after opening the file pointer moves to the 7th byte. So after moving the cursor, we are reading by using the fin.read operation, and then we are printing the data. Now let us see what will happen. Run the program. So see, this VR is not there. It starts from learning Python. So you got the result as learning Python and the entire content of the data. Okay. Now another one function we have for reading, that is, suppose if you want to read a specified number of characters from a file, suppose you want to read the first 10 characters from a file, you can specify the number of bytes you want to read in the read function. For example, here I am giving read of 10. That means it will read the first 10 characters starting from the cursor position. Okay. Now I have commented this fin.secops and I have commented this one. Now let us run it once again. Now you got the first 10 characters from this file. So the read function reads the entire content of the data starting from the cursor position, and read of within bracket, if you are specifying a byte, it will reads the specified number of characters from the file. Now let us check what is the type of this data. Just I am printing print type of data. Now let us see what is the type of this variable. Run it once again. So you will get class string. That means the data from the file you got in the form of a string. It is a string. Okay. Now we have another one function called read line for reading data from the file. Read function you have. Another one function is read line. We can specify instead of line, you can give read line. This read line function reads one line from the file. Now let us once again run this program. Let us check. See, you got the result as we are learning Python. That is the first line of the demo.txt file. You can see here, we are learning Python. This is the first line of the file demo.txt. So this read line function reads one line from the file, and that is also a type string type. Data is a string type data. Okay, this is the read line function, and you can also read a line starting from another one cursor position. Okay, if suppose for example, if I am omitting this comment, once again I am running it. It starts from the 7th byte, and from the 7th byte it reads a one line. So you will get learning Python. You won't get we are learning Python. You will get learning Python. It is omitting the first 7 bytes. Okay. Now Python gives you one more function for reading, that is read lines. So this read lines function reads the entire content of the data, something like read function. Now let us once again type execute this program. See, you can see the result in the form of a list. So when you are using read lines function, it reads the entire content of the data starting from the cursor position, but it's saved in the form of a list. In read and read line, you will get the data in the form of a string, but in the case of read lines, you will get the data in the form of a list. That's why it is displayed class list. The type of the data is list in this case. So for reading from the file, first you should open the file, and then you can use read, read line and read lines function. Read and read reads the entire data from the cursor position. Starting from the cursor position, and the read lines function also reads the entire data starting from the cursor position, but it's displayed in the form of a list. Okay, hope you all have understood this one. That's all for today's session. Thank you.